Hi folks, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me today. At 9:08 a.m. local time there in Puerto Rico off the coast, there was a magnitude 4.5 earthquake that 180 people so far said they felt. There is no tsunami warning. The only thing that they have on tsunami.gov is a 4.8, which I can't find. They give the longitude and longitude. It's on land, which is kind of odd. They don't even list the 4.6. So here's the area of the 4.6. And up over here is the 4.8. Yeah, they're saying there's no tsunami warning. This area has had some large earthquakes in the past. Or actually maybe moderate earthquakes. The largest being in 2020. Was a magnitude 6.4. Also, we got a 5.6 in 2020, 2019, a 5.0, and a 5.8 in 2020. So I even checked the Puerto Rico Seismic Network. The only thing they have now, they only list felt reports. Here we got a 4.5. There was also a 3.9. Let me bring it over a little bit. That was Eastern Dominican Republic. A 3.93 for septentrial fault zone. There was also a 3.62 in the Sombrero fault zone. Now, those were all yesterday. There's only one that they're reporting today, and that's the 4.5. Like I said, that's all just felt reports. This from EMSC for that magnitude 4.5. A report says it was strong. Another one said it was strong. We'll have to translate this. The vibration was felt from afar until the moment of things in the house was felt. Let's see. Light shaking, maybe about 4.4, about 1.5 seconds. There were 21 kilometers north. So that would be about 13 miles. And they're just giving the areas where they felt it here, it looks like. Another one says, it felt almost a 5 in Barrio. I'm not going to try and pronounce that. Another one said it was large. This other one says it was heard and then it was felt. So when you hear it first, that's the first wave of the earthquake, which would be the P wave. Strong and long in San German. Shook their chair like a truck coming your way. That one said it was light. That was 33 kilometers. So that would be about 20.5 miles. Another one says it was a little hard, the shaken ponce. What else do we got here? Tremor felt here in ponce. Another one, this translates kind of cute, and hills. The noise was heard. Let's see, a loud noise and movement. Now another one said it was very strong. They were 42 kilometers northwest. So that would be about 26 miles. Another one in real Puerto Rico, sitting on the couch, felt like someone bumped the back of the couch. It would depend on the type of structure and the type of soil that the building is sitting on for how strong or how weak it would have felt. Here it said it was somewhat strong, lasted about 3 seconds or more. Another one said strong, everything trembled. More or less moderate. Now this one is about 44 miles north. It says very strong, as if the floor was being pushed up. She was sitting in the dining room chair and the chair moved in that way, and I tell you, as if it was pushed from under the ground. In the past month, there's been 79 earthquakes just within this one area, the southern end of Puerto Rico, and this was the largest earthquake they've had within a month. Now, this map shows significant earthquakes. I'm not sure how far back it goes, but the largest being a magnitude, let me pull it over, the 6.4, which was in 2020. They have 16 listed, and it looks like all of them were probably over a magnitude 4.5 or greater. So it's been a while since they had anything significant in that location. And people know if they do have a large earthquake, they should evacuate straight up because of the threat of tsunamis. Here it says, in the 20th century alone, there has been several very large earthquakes north of Puerto Rico, a magnitude 7.3 in 1918, a 7.8 in 1943, a 8.0 in 1946, and four major aftershocks, a 7.6, a 7.0, a 7.3, 7.4, between 1946 and 1953. Large tsunamis have also hit Puerto Rico and Hispaniola, reportedly killing 1,800 people in 1946 and 40 people in 1918. So going back to Google Earth. Okay, and I only put a couple of the earthquakes. Over here in the Mona Passage in 1918, the Mona Canyon. There was a 7.1 that created an earthquake, and tsunami. And this is the one in 1946. No people were killed in Puerto Rico, but quite a few people there in the Dominican Republic were killed from the magnitude 8.1. Yeah, this Mona Canyon is an area of spreading, but what we got going on is crushing. We got the North American plate subducting underneath the Caribbean plate. And then we got the Minerto's Trough, which is also another area of large earthquakes. And yeah, that's moving north. Oh, and over here we got 1867. That was a magnitude 7.5. So did you feel dizzy during this earthquake, and how did your pets react? Yeah, magnitude 4s and 5s are fairly common. They do cause damage and injuries. Yeah, and the buildings there really aren't made to be earthquake proof. So sending prayers to everybody on this Easter Sunday. Stay blessed, stay prepared, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.